Hello, brothers and sisters, and welcome to my best places where I come and try to keep it down and need to entertainment and to go over to me and some very fucking important, because everything I say is important.
Oh my goodness. Hello, brothers and sisters of light and dark. When I say light, I mean all those who are blinded, which is the masses, who are going down the broad road of destruction, who live through fear and who live through religion, who live through an external source of God. That's the light, people. People who are blinded by the light, because the light is easily misleading. Fear. Remember, fear. The acronym of fear is basically false evidence appearing real. And most people are in that delusion. Okay. Those people in the dark are like me, on the left-hand path, who actually pretty much know the knowledge. They naturally know the knowledge. They're indigo children, Asperger's individuals, star seed children, people who basically are schizophrenia, people who hear the voices, people who see the third eye, people who say they're Jesus, people who say they are the Holy Spirit, people who say who are they pure. That's me. Very rare and far and few between. I-N-G. What do you call it? Inert, okay, individuals, especially internalized agnostic and gnostic individuals, and agnostic, not atheists. They're not atheists, but they may consider themselves, okay, special, okay. But of course, these individuals, what are you doing?
I'm finished.
Okay, so sign out and sign back into my name and play, okay. Now it's about over 1 minute. But this video is going to be about, if you have any comments, questions, or insults, you put it down below, okay? And I also post down evidence that I've been in Ethiopia, and I will tell you how to get Ethiopian women. Oh, yay! Some guys actually hit me up on my comment section, and they usually say, hey, talk about Ethiopia more, talk about Ethiopia more, talk about Ethiopia more, talk about Ethiopia more. But hey, I'm going to talk about Ethiopia, but not too much, because I already... And you going back to Marty's Knowledge, the first one, subscribe to that one, okay? And look at all of the videos in there, okay? All right, sometime I'll post a new video up on there. And another thing, too, I'm not at 500. All my videos is not a total of 500 videos. I have 490, I think 490 videos now. So I'll make like 10 more videos. Then I'll go into Marty's Knowledge 3. It's listed under comedy, so if you take it, seriously, I don't like sensitive folks. I don't like people who don't ask questions. You should fly your ass off the page, okay? You can donate to me to the bottom. I don't monetize my pages for a reason. Because I get my money from extra external sources, okay? I'm a noble individual. I don't do things for money. I'm a very noble individual. Not ambitious. Now, okay, how to get Ethiopian women is fairly fucking easy. And you don't even need to know English, nor the language. In the description box, I'm going to put down, you can check all the fine females. But I wish I could have showed their bodies, though, because some of them females who are Ethiopian had fucked up teeth, but they had beautiful bodies, fantastic bodies, okay? Fantastic body. And you may ask me, oh, how do you get a chance to walk around and shit like that while you have a wife? You're married. I say, well, because basically I can, because I'm the real McCoy motherfucker. That's a little disrespect. That wasn't, my whole goal was not to go over there just to have sex, okay? My goal is to inspect. My goal was not to have sex, but and to inspect. Okay, that rhymed, did it? I'm the guy who used the dildos and see how the muscle works upon the dildo. Okay, and see how perverted that may sound, but a lot of guys don't do that shit. I don't lose my real penis with females who are not virgins. But I'm gonna get to the point. I'm gonna get to the point here. I'm trying to give you a description of how I feel about Ethiopian women, Habesha women. Okay, hallelujah. Now, I don't care what you may think about my wife. You may think that she came over here just to use me. But I did not mind that because I'm a psychopath. And I don't mind if people try to use me so I can take advantage of them. Okay, you know what I'm saying? You see how that works? Okay, it's a two-edged sword there. She try to use me and then I try to use her. Okay, see? If she messes up, then I get the advantage. Okay, and that's the whole purpose. Ding, ding, ding. Courts don't work with me because I read the courts. Okay, so I'm emerald pill, motherfucker. I'm our emerald pill. Go. I'll put that down in the description box. Emerald pill, Ethiopian girl 1-7. Okay, check it out. Now, if you looked at my past videos in Matthias Knowledge, the first one, you'll notice that I actually lived there for almost 2 years. I lost my passport, and I walked around in the day and also at night. And a lot of them females had nice asses, okay? And small waist. They had calcified teeth, you know, shitty teeth, okay? Right, my love? Didn't you have shitty teeth? I got your teeth cleaned. I got them shitty teeth cleaned. Look like the goddamn sewer and shit like that. Drinking all that goddamn coffee and shit. Right? But then I ran encountered some men who basically had knowledge of women out there. They called bar ladies. Okay, I was in Tedes Hotel, Maya Hotel, Raz Resort, A-Last Resort, Blue Bonnet. I think it was Blue Bonnet. Algas, you know, I've been to all of them fucking hotels. Yes, I have. And scanning around. But at first, when I first got down there, I was just walking to females and talking to them. Okay? And I didn't know what to do. So they would reject me straight up because I didn't show them the money. So basically, if you really want to know how to, I encountered a guy who basically, he's my friend down there, who told me, you show him the money, man. You show him the money. Inibana. Show him the money, inibana. And they will go. A roll full of money. And out of that roll of that money, you're going to take 100 birr. $1 is worth 22 birr. Now you understand how much it costs. It's, most prostitutes can be bought for 200 birr. Did you know that? Yes, that's what he told me. And of course, my friend tells me, okay, you roll up to them, and if you got the money, they'll always be your hoe, okay? So you're going to do some pimping out there and shit, but the only problem is that they didn't know English. That's my problem with it. I'm like, I was trying to bring some of them girls to my fucking house to meet my wife, okay? I was trying to do that. But it didn't work because they didn't know how to keep in touch. They don't know how to dial a number. They don't know the times. They don't even know what the fuck I'm saying because I'm speaking completely in English. And some of the motherfuckers be thinking I'm fucking Ethiopian because the color of my skin. They don't see the features of my face is completely different from most of their faces. But until they look at my clothes and shit. Okay. So that's the answer right there. So you go out there, you carry yourself a wad of cash, not maybe 1,000. You don't need to carry too much because you can get robbed. Because I'm a fighter. I'll be looking for fights. I'll be trying to wait. Wait until a motherfucker pull out a gun on me. You gotta be three motherfuckers at one angle and shit. I'm trying to kill somebody out there. That's my mentality when I go out somewhere. I'm trying to kill somebody. Okay? I'm trying to protect my own self. I keep my mouth shut. I respect everything. But when someone come off of some way, I'm just gonna disarm you. I'm gonna disarm you very quickly. Because I fear for my life. But if you carry that money and you know the landmarks on how to meet these females, you meet me at the Dashin Bank. You meet me at Dashin Bank. You meet me at Commercial Bank. Okay, that's the names of their major banks out there. Dashin Bank, Commercial Bank, or a place you know. Right across the streets from Tedes Hotel or a Raz Resort or a Maya Hotel. Okay, because those locations was actually in Adama Nazareth. You carry your money on you. You show them around and say, hey, you know, inibana, you know, inibana. That's all you need to say. And they'll be like, hey, me no money, me no money. You know what I'm saying? There you go. They don't talk like that, though. But it's fairly as easy as that. They don't know English. I say, do you know English? Inibana? Okay, inibana? ETB, Ethiopian bird. Okay, trust me. 90% of them are bar ladies, okay? Especially in underdeveloped countries. As a matter of fact, they can't be bar ladies too much if you go in underdeveloped countries because they don't know no better. Okay, but if you go to the cities like Addis Ababa and Hawassa, they're definitely going to be bar ladies. And they're more likely to understand you through English terminologies. Turn it down. Please. So that's the way how you get Ethiopian women. You don't have to look pretty or anything. You just have to have the money, okay? You have the money, honey, you can take care of it. And since I didn't know that at a late time, I learned it at a later time when I was about to leave. And I was like, oh, it's too late. I could have recorded more women naked. I can't show women naked on these fucking videos. Okay. I get in trouble and shit. All I want to do is record them and massage them with some baby oil. Right? Okay. So peace and love to you, brothers and sisters of Light and Dark. All you need is the bird. Ini bada. Ini bada. It means I want to fuck, or I want to have sex. My friend told me this shit. He actually tried to hook me up with a couple girls. Okay, but I didn't show the money. You get wasted money at. You don't got the money. You ain't showing it in their face. Two women at a time, baby. Two women at a time. Three women at a time. You just have to have the pizzazz to say it. Okay. Peace and love to you, brothers and sisters of Light and Dark. Welcome to my page. And you have a nice fucking day. Okay? And don't get AIDS, okay? I don't like condoms. Okay? Peace.